Hello YouTube people. So I've been away for a month now. I'm very sure you're going to be asking for some explanation. I don't have any explanation, bruh. I've been having the time of my life. I mean, I've been sleeping, I've been partying, I've been having the time of my life. Okay, that's not true. Scrap that. That's bullshit. Before I went away, I was having anxiety. I was having a lot of anxiety. I was also having seasonal depression. I was in my finals, so I had projects, I had exams, I had FYB this, FYB that, church this, church that. I had a lot of things to do. Everything was too much to undo. I had a lot of responsibilities. I was just overwhelmed, and there was YouTube by the side. So I was like, if I can't take a break from those things, if I can't take a break from school, then I would take a break from YouTube. So I just had to disappear. I started this channel 6 months ago.
So I have done it. I have started. This is my first video.
I didn't know what I wanted to do or how I wanted to go about it, but I just needed to start. Like always, my anxiety was beginning to win, and I'm like, no, not now, devil, not today. I just needed to start, and I started, and it's been a ride. It's been exciting, but mostly hard. Especially in recent times, it has been hard to create. I've encountered troubles every time I try to create. Let me take you through the process. So it usually starts with an idea, yeah? Most of it comes in the middle of the night, though. And most times, before I film a video, I already have the ideas from weeks back, and I've written it down. Then I go ahead to plan. Yes, I plan. I have a YouTube journal that I write my ideas in and make plans. How do I want to edit the video? Where do I want to make it? What emotions do I want to pass across? And all that stuff. After I plan, I go ahead to fight with what clothes to wear, which is also a big struggle. After I choose clothes, I sit down to film, which is not also a smooth process. Sometimes I start to doubt myself, and I call my people to rant about it.
The background is not giving what it's meant to give. I don't like it. My plant is even dying. What if this video is even stupid? What if people are not even interested and they don't watch it? I don't even know if I'm doing something sensitive with this video.
Sometimes the video is dependent on people's responses, and that does not always go well too.
I'm filming a video. Yes, the saint of shots is that I said people should ask me questions, and if I cannot answer it, I will drink. Nobody answered me, oh. Voila. Everybody hear my papa. Oh God, how will I now do the video? Let me go and ask them individually.
After I film, I edit. That can go on for days. But during editing, my laptop can start acting up. Reason why I've started editing on my phone, which is not also easy. It is very hard. Editing app will show you shiggy. After editing, my video is ready to be uploaded. YouTube will not start their own wahala. Sometimes they will say I've used copyrighted music. So copyrighted music is a song that is licensed to somebody. Imagine using Davido's song or Lamide's song or just one foreign artist that you don't even know. You can use it in your video, but there are many wahala to copyright the music. So I have to take the video down, look for a new song, and re-edit. Another wahala. The one that has been happening recently is that my video will get stuck in SD processing. That is, my video will just be processing. It will not upload. Video that I'm supposed to upload on Saturday, I will not be uploading it like 2 days after because my video is still processing. It's a whole lot of struggle.
So it's me doing all that and not posting my videos because I feel like they are not good enough, or posting them and them not getting as much views as I expect. I know it's baby steps. I know I just started. I know I have not put out a lot of videos, but I put in a moderate amount of work in my videos, and I think it's fair for me to expect a return in views, a return in how people watch them.
I started this channel for me, I started it for myself, and I said I was not going to forget that. Before now, I would do things and I would do them because I love to do them. I would make up for people and just do it because I love it. I would draw and it didn't need to be perfect. I would edit a video and I would just do it because I love it and I will enjoy it. But now, because I am putting out this video for people to consume, because people are watching it, I am concentrating on people liking these videos. I'm concentrating on if people love these videos more than if I love putting them out. And I feel like if people love them, people will watch them, and if they watch them, they will do good numbers. And so because they are not doing good numbers, because the views are not up to what I expect, I'm beginning to think, maybe I'm not so good, maybe I'm not that good, maybe these videos are not so good, maybe I'm not good enough. I'm beginning to doubt myself, and that shouldn't be. It's not just about the numbers. I'm also very particular about the quality of my videos. I'm a perfectionist. I want everything to be on check. I want to do the best with the little that I have. Even if I'm not going to be 100, I want to do the best of my ability. So I get frustrated when I want to make videos. I make videos and they are not up to my expectations. They are not up to my standard. And
I'm my biggest critic. I know what to do.
And I am not very equipped. I don't have enough facilities. I don't have enough equipment.
So when people point things out in my videos, they don't work well with me. I don't work well with criticism. When people say, change this, do that, I get more anxious. I'm like, oh, they noticed. Oh, they are saying this. And it puts me under pressure. I feel like I need to do more. I need to do this. So I'm going maybe on a pace that is not comfortable for me. I'm meant to get more gadgets. I'm meant to get plants. I'm meant to do this. I'm up to up my equipment game. Well, I cannot do it. Like, I'm not equipped. I don't have money.
I enjoy myself, but it's not what I came here for.
I feel like many people don't even talk about the fact that creatives have to have or use their money to make more money. A makeup artist have to start using her money to buy makeup stuff before she can get money from clients to buy other things. A YouTuber has to use his or her money to buy camera and microphone and all that before YouTube money start coming in and all that. I sat down one day to think to myself that if a 12-year-old wanted to create, he or she is going to start with whatever device he or she has. Their parents may not see the vision at first, so they will probably just buy a phone for them and tell them, start with this phone. And people are going to listen to the 12-year-old if they have something sensible to say. I think that creating content should be more about value, the value that you put out. Are you putting out something entertaining, educating? Are you giving people value for their time? I think it should be more of what somebody wants to say and what somebody is putting out than the kind of camera they use, how clear their video are, how clear the audio is, and all that. I'm also forgetting that YouTube is a form of self-expression. I'm forgetting that YouTube does not have to be that serious. It's about doing the thing that you love and finding a community of people that resonate with you. There is always an audience. There's always an audience for you. No matter what you do, there is always an audience. I mean, on the internet, on YouTube, there is a particular video of how to boil egg, and more than a million people have watched that video. Like, do people not know how to boil egg? Whoever owns that channel, that is their audience. Their audience have found them, and their audience have watched. I need to stop seeking validation from these numbers. These numbers don't define how good I am. I need to know that growth, timing, and luck are a thing. It is a learning curve. I know many people feel this way too, unsure about whatever we're doing, unsure about wherever we are in this point of life, doubting ourselves, and maybe being too hard on ourselves. I just want us to know that we're trying our best, we're doing well, and that's all that matters. What matters is to continue doing what we love, to keep going at it, to keep doing it. The world will catch up.
Don't believe in yourself. Who will believe for you? Nobody, man. That's the truth about it. You have to believe in yourself because you know you can do it. And once you believe, you can never achieve.
I think that people should allow creatives to grow, especially people that just started. Let them grow. With time, they will have better equipment. With time, the quality of their videos will improve. I also need to tell myself, Tife, you need to allow yourself grow. You need to move on your own pace. I just started. I should not be rushing myself. I should not be doing more than I can do. I'm trying my best. I'm doing well. I'm brilliant. And I should not forget that. I also know that it's not always going to be smooth. people are not always going to watch my videos. I'm going to probably get frustrated once in a while, but I'll keep doing it. I just wanted to show you guys my process. I just wanted to tell you guys how hard it is and how hard it has been for me. I just wanted to tell you guys that I've been doubting myself. So if I go for another 2 months, I'm probably doubting myself again. I've said many things in this video, and I meant to remember. I've said I'm brilliant, and whenever I want to create again, I'm supposed to remember that I'm brilliant. But that's what happened. I forget again that I'm brilliant and that I'm doing good. So if I disappear again, which I hope I don't, it's probably why.
If you must wait, wait for them here in my arms as I shake.